Morning coffee tastes like there's no use for me to getting up again. And then I dream your lips onto my skin.
Catherine Ann Porter said that each generation must go on the same old merry-go-round, only disguised in a fresh coat of paint. And then Ralph Ellison said, "Everywhere I've turned, somebody has wanted to sacrifice me for my own good. Only they were the ones who benefited. And now we start on the old sacrificial merry-go-round. At what point do we stop?" Happy Tuesday. Welcome back to Morning Coffee. I'm Rick Alexander. You guys can follow along with me at @RickAlexander_ and at the Morning Coffee Podcast on Instagram. Of course, we have the immersion program for the Clarity Academy, which we would like to run on September 27th in the Outer Banks of North Carolina. So if you're interested in an intensive weekend learning about yourself, really doing some self-exploration to figure out who you really are, and then maybe how to get to the life that you actually want, that's the whole purpose of this Clarity Academy weekends. You can go to rickalexander.com to sign up, and you could just enter a deposit. All right, so today I'm going to talk about a concept from my newest book. And if you guys haven't caught on, I've actually stopped talking about when I'm going to release that book because it's been a lot. Me just figuring out the process of writing and what I want it to be. And, you know, the interesting thing is that I've evolved, my thoughts have evolved. And so I've had to continuously go back and recapitulate my picture of what I'm looking to do in this book. And so I finally do believe I'm on the route to having it done soon. But again, I'm going to stop even talking about when it's going to be out, because at this point, I care much more about releasing a really good book than I do releasing a book at all. Of course, if you are interested in books by me, you can check out Burn Your Couch on Amazon or off my website. But today, I'm going to talk about The Insane Merry-Go-Round, which is chapter 3 from my newest book. You know, as certain thoughts and quotes are propagated through, well, social media and all the new media outlets, our collective consciousness tends to perpetuate ones that resonate on a certain level. Now, usually it's just because it makes sense for the level of consciousness that we're all at, as in like our understanding. And so sometimes you'll see quotes that are propagated over and over and over, and it's because they collectively are understood by so many. So one of the most common among these is the Albert Einstein definition of insanity. He said doing the same thing over and over again and expecting different results. You've heard that on every motivational YouTube video and post, whatever. And this resonates in part because its simplicity makes it easy to recite, but far more difficult to act on, meaning we all say it, and very few do it. And I'd love to talk about why. See, the thing that makes it so hard is that we are taught to think in very similar ways because the worldview that our thoughts are born out of tends to be similar. We think in tracks that all lead us to a similar outcome. And so think about this as far as, like, probably if you're listening to this, you come from a society that's been influenced by Western culture, even if you're not part of it. And what's interesting is in Western culture, we tend to value the same things collectively. And so we think in the same tracks. And so all of our thinking, we sort of live pretty similar lives because we're all thinking the exact same way, right? We're all on the same roads driving the same direction. That's, again, like the collective consciousness that I'm talking about. And so when we think in tracks, of course, we all get to the similar outcome. But what this means is that you could try many different things throughout the course of your life to get a different outcome. But if all of those attempts are encapsulated in the same thinking, well, then you're going to get the same result. And so, you know, what's interesting is in the Clarity Academy, the whole first module is designed to help us develop new ways of thinking, because the ways of thinking that we all have are getting us the same results. And so on some level, if you've continued to try to get a different life over and over and you're unable to do so, well, it's your thinking that's leading you down that route. So you could try many different things to get what you want, but if you're thinking the same way, all of those attempts are going to be encapsulated in the same thought process. And so you're going to get the same result. That is what I call the insane merry-go-round. And the idea of the merry-go-round is that we're all going around and around all of these revolutions, but we're not getting anywhere else. We're not getting anywhere different. It's our thinking that creates the merry-go-round, and it's our perpetuating of our thinking that continues it moving without getting a different result. So in 2020, the barrier to do any one thing that you might want to do is no longer external, meaning outside of us. Because, you know, it used to be that in order to break into any one industry, your dues had to be paid. You had to convince the powers that be that you are worthy or whatever you want by incessant errand running and networking with people that may or may not deserve your time and just generally climbing the proverbial ladders, right? And with the prevalence of new technology, new media outlets, and open source information, the barrier to entry is now you. And I think that I am a living example of this because I have a radio show and I brought nobody coffee for any amount of time in order for them to tell me that I was able to share my thoughts with the world. And right now we're downloaded in about 74 different countries. And so the barrier to entry is, can you find a creative angle that will help you pursue what you want to? Can you persist on the path when you aren't getting the validation you'd hoped and not abandon it for what your parents have laid out as quote-unquote safe? And just as a general rule throughout my life, what I've come to find out is that what most people view as safe, I actually view as a cage. But it is true that the greatest possible outcome requires the greatest possible sacrifice that you can make. Now, I've talked about this over and over, right? Because what you need to understand is that the greatest sacrifice you can make is the thing that you hold dearest, which is, of course, your belief system. And you guys have heard me say that over and over. And you know what's interesting is you could hear me say that. Your level of consciousness might not be at a height where you actually understand what that means and the implications of it in your life. But when you actually start to grapple with your thoughts and start to dismiss like old beliefs and patterns and programs that your parents have put in you for, it is the substructure of your reality. And so when you start pulling at those, it's so destabilizing because you're pulling at the substructure of your reality. It's not easy to change your thinking. It's really, really difficult, and you've got to grapple, and it's a process of going through the underworld in order to do it. But I think right now my request is that you just hold space for what you don't yet know. I think that's the way to start, because all great wisdom will require that of you. If you aren't getting the life you want, it's because you're bouncing off the outer edge of your belief system and you're calling it reality. There couldn't possibly be another reason. Most people are cynical about reality because they've mistaken their limiting beliefs for the outer edges of it. So open yourself to a new way of thinking and you'll open yourself up to the possibility of a different result. And there is no way. And so ask yourself, whatever it is I'm trying to get in my life, why do I keep trying it? Or what are the ways that I'm trying it? And then what way of thinking is encapsulating all of the different attempts that I've tried? So maybe let's say that you're after contentment or happiness. Almost everybody actually is, right? So that's a good one. And so maybe you've tried it through all of these different jobs, and you've tried it through going to school, and you've tried it through, I don't know, let's say corporate religious practice, and you have all these attempts, and it's like sometimes you're close, but it always seems elusive. There's always a part of you that feels missing, and that's pretty common in life. And so the thing to ask yourself is, what is the overall belief system that all of these different attempts are encapsulated in? Because maybe you're just thinking exactly how your parents thinking, and you're trying different outlets, but they're all for naught because they're all trying the exact same thing in essence, because your thinking hasn't changed. Maybe you got to throw the playbook out, right? Maybe it's not about rewriting it. Maybe it's about throwing it out and just starting from a blank canvas as best as you can. Maybe the implied narrative that has been passed down to you that you're not even aware of is that there is somewhere to get. And so all of the things you're trying are trying to get to this elusive place of contentment. Like, if I have the benefits and I have the job and I have the money and I have the spouse or the fence or the mortgage or whatever, right? And it's maybe the way that you're thinking about it is wrong, because maybe if you listen to me long enough, I'll convince you that there is nowhere to get, that all of it is an experience and that the decisions you make should be put through that lens. So does this decision help me to express this life in the way that I actually want to, or am I acting as if there is somewhere to get and putting all of my contentment in that thing? And you might not even notice you're doing it, because again, it's the substructure of your reality. It's the lens you're looking through. That's what makes it so hard to change. You don't feel like there's another option because it literally encapsulates your whole entire world, but there's always another option. Very hard to do, but it's worth asking yourself, where is my thinking leading me to a less than stellar existence? Because most likely, if your existence is less than stellar or less than you want it to be, it can only be your thinking that is allowing that thing to happen. At least that's the way I understand it. But I love you guys. We'll talk tomorrow on Morning Coffee.
If you ain't got two kids by 21, you're probably gonna die alone. At least that's what tradition told you. And it don't matter. Sunday morning, you best be there in the front row like you're supposed to. same trailer, different park. Mama's hooked on Mary Kay, brother's hooked on Mary Jane, and daddy's hooked on Mary two doors down. Mary, Mary, quack and Sherry, we get bored so we get married, and just like dust we settle in this town. On this broken merry-go-round, round, round we go, where it stops nobody knows, and it ain't slowing down, this merry-go-round. We think the first time's good enough, so we hold on to high school love, say we won't end up. Happy in the shoes you wear. Same checks are always cashing to buy a little more distraction. 'Cause mama's hooked on Mary Kay, brother's hooked on Mary Jane, and daddy's hooked on Mary two doors down. Mary, Mary, quite contrary, Jack burned out on booze and pills.